It has been a minute since we were last here. I want to say that it was 2019, but it could be 2018. But in my 8 years of serving in Jefferson Christian Academy, I've been here three times before. One was unofficial, and the other two were with the choir when I was taking care of it until now. This will be the fourth. And so I know the school has been here a lot of times before. And this is one of the churches that we've always looked forward to come to. One of our board members is here. And so we look forward to seeing him here every time we come. If I may give a rundown of our program today, we will have two songs from our bell choir, and then we'll ask the choir, voice choir, to come up, and they'll give us four songs. And after that, we'll ask the brass band to give us three. Then after that, we'll ask the choir to come back and finish off. Okay? Or brass, and then bells again will come back. So the bells will play five today. So I hope you'll be blessed by all of this. Go on any further, let me pray one more time. Heavenly Father, we thank you again. It is never about us, it is all about you. So I'm asking you, Holy Spirit, to be present with us, and please sing with us, play with us, as always, as you would be faithful to us. Bless us all today, in Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you.
Good morning and happy Sabbath again. And as our choir maketh their way up here, a couple of things I want to say. I know it has been a long time since we've been here. And again, as my wife has said, 8 years we have been at Jefferson Christian Academy. In 8 years, Earl Hale was our chairman of our board, our president, right? So he was our leader for a very long time. And we totally appreciate his leadership at the school, and he's done so much. So it's good to see you here today. You know, there's a lot that has been done, and I don't think I'm going to make it up there by the looks of it. So I'm just going to speak and then go sit down. But a lot has been done since the last time we've been here. The last time before we were here, our boys' dorm has been remodeled, and that's all by the generosity of loved ones and church members and those that have graduated, alumni of Jefferson Christian Academy, and of course of the board members of Jefferson Christian Academy too. There was a church, Jefferson Central, actually came to do a mission work at Jefferson. They came with $3,500, okay, and they wanted to remodel the school. Well, during their whole time there, as they were doing their work, we started to show little clips of videos of what they were doing. And people started to write on Facebook and say, hey, what can we do to help? Well, they wrote, and we told them how they can help, and they contributed. And it ended up with almost over $30,000 that people helped out, and we were able to remodel the boys' dorm. Another thing that has been done, we bought a feed store in town of Jefferson, and we turned it into a store, the front part of it, and in the back it was a warehouse, and we turned it into a climate control storage. And so a couple of those units we started, and when we opened it, it got filled up pretty quickly. So our board decided to build more. So we started that the beginning of the year. Is that right, Earl? We started that the beginning of this year. Well, it is completed. We opened it 2 weeks ago, and again, those units are getting filled up. And so we praise the Lord for that. And Mount Pleasant, I know I'm here because I want to thank you all for always helping the school, and thank you for always willing to give your time and financially support the school. And we're so thankful for all of your help. And so many things have been done. And I know that the project, there's some need of help with the project to be completely be done with. And what we did was we actually helped... we actually asked for help of alumni and people around Jefferson, and they actually gave, and they were able to support the project, and we were able to build this storage units, and we were able to finally open 2 weeks ago. And only by God's grace, things are getting done at the school, and we appreciate the help of everyone. If it wasn't for the community, if it wasn't for people like you, your church members that give, I believe that these projects would not be able to be completed. And so we are thankful for all of your generosity and all of your help. I will let them sing. And like I said, I'm not going to make it up there. So I'm just going to sit down here and also watch and probably sing from here. So once again, thank you all for your love. Thank you for allowing us to be here. And I pray that you will be blessed by the rest of the program. Thank you.
And we will continue on to sing about his mercy. You know what? So many times, and I will not talk about anybody else. I'll just talk about myself and what we experience back at school. You know, so many times we face trials and burdens that, you know, sometimes we sit down and look at it and just thinking, we don't know how to face this. But the Lord is faithful always. And he has done this for us over and over again. Need I say the problems? I don't think so, because all of us are going through that. And I'm sure, Earl, you know all of that. I can't tell you any more than you already know. But I know for a fact that the Lord had done it in the past, and we are going to see it again. He's faithful, and he'll do it again.
Again. He'll do it again.
Just
Next month, we will be talking a lot more about how Jesus died on the cross for you and I. But not only that, we know from day one to the end of your life that He had given His all for you and I. He left it all, is the next song that we're about to sing. You know what? We're not professional singers, but we would love to sing and do anything for God as far as it's music. With the best that we can do. Yeah. So this song here, please pay attention more to the lyrics. He left it all. It's a song that we're about to sing now. I know for a fact that if it hadn't been for Him, when He left it all because of me, if I was the only one who sinned and was ugly and bad, He will die. He'll leave it all just for me. So if you put it to yourself, and you know you can personalize that just between you and God, it means a whole lot more. Okay, so I pray that you'll be blessed by this.
He walked away.
This is our last song for this round, and it will be I'm Gonna Keep On Working Till He Comes. And I think I only speak for all of us that work in chasing. I can't believe it's 8 years already for us serving that. It doesn't feel that long at all. But I believe, knowing the God that had gave, that had given all for me, I can't say any more than just to say, I'll keep on working till you come back. And I pray that we all just, we do the same. And you don't have to be a missionary to just do God's work. You can do your work out there for God. And so I hope that we will be blessed by this one. I'm going to keep on working till he comes.
I'm gonna keep on working till he comes, till he comes. There's nothing in this world worth turning around to see. My eyes are on the prize that's awaiting me by and by. And I'm gonna keep on working till he comes. Oh,
I'm gonna,
yes, I'm gonna keep on working till he comes, till he comes.
You know
there's nothing in this world we're turning around to see.
My eyes
are on the prize that's awaiting me by and by.
I'm gonna
keep on working till he comes. Oh,
there's work to be done,
victories to be won. There's joys up the road that have never yet been told. There are treasures that we need in that land by faith I see.
I'm gonna keep on working
till he comes. Oh,
I'm gonna keep on working
till he comes, till he comes.
You know
there's nothing in this world we're turning around to see.
My eyes
are on the prize that's awaiting me by and by.
I'm gonna keep on working
till he comes. Oh,
there's a message to be preached, lots of souls that have to be reached. There's hungry to be fed, little children to be led. There's a river flowing free in that land by faith I see.
I'm gonna keep on working till he comes. Oh,
I'm gonna keep on working
till he comes, till he comes.
You know
there's nothing in this world we're turning around to see.
My eyes
are on the prize that's awaiting me by and by.
I'm gonna keep on working
till he comes.
I'm gonna keep working. There's nothing in this world we're turning around to see. My eyes are on the prize
that's awaiting me by and by.
I'm gonna keep on working
till he comes. Oh, yeah.
This time I would like to ask the brass band to give us 3 songs, and after that we'll give it to the Bell Choir to give us 3 songs, and then we'll resume back with the choir, and that will be ending our sermon in music today.
Thank you. Thank you. Are you blessed so far, church?
Amen.
You know, I have to be honest. Where the bell, they practice right in front of my office in the chapel, and so my office faces them. And you know, there's nothing like an end product or the day of performance, because some of the kids have asked me, why aren't you, you're never around when we practice? And I didn't tell them, but I'll tell you now, because it's annoying. You know, practice are annoying, but when you hear the end product, it is a blessing. So, you know, as my wife or my sister talked about, we usually go and participate in Ring Fest, which is in Toledo, Ohio. And there's like 18 schools that attend this Ring Fest. And you can just imagine this big church and all of the bells, and we're one of the smallest group there is. And you hear these 18 schools play, and it's just a blessing. I just want to, before they sing the last song, or are you guys okay with two songs? All right, we're going to sing two more songs. I just want to let you all know that the love offering that you will be given goes to a lot of the things that these young people go through. One of them is, of course, traveling expenses that these young people do every weekend. Next week will be probably the only second weekend that we're actually at the church or at school on campus. Usually after school on Friday, we leave and we do not come back until Saturday night or Sunday. We travel. These kids are out praising the Lord and sharing the word of God through music. And it is a blessing. So that goes with there. This month, February 28th, the entire school, every face that you see up here except for two, they're not here. We have 23 kids, and there's two kids that are not here. But everyone that you see up here will be going on this mission trip. We are going to Juneau, Alaska. I've never been there. I know Woo means cold, right? So they will be going to Juneau, Alaska. And, you know, when we had made plans, our pastor made plans to go up there, the first thing I always do is look for a place for our kids to stay. Because knowing that it's cold, I had to find a place. So I saw on the map that there was a Seventh-day Adventist school. So I called them. I called the school, and the principal answered the phone, and we started to talk. I told him about our bells, our brass, our choir. She was excited. But then at the end of our conversation, she said, but the thing is, we don't have any students. This school in Alaska have no students. They were closed this year because they didn't have any students at all. There was no kids coming. So this month, we will be going there. We're going to do a week of prayer. We're going to do VBS. We're going to go around the neighborhood and try to advertise this little school. Imagine that. A school of just 23 kids going to Juneau, Alaska to help a school with no students at all. So there's going to be work that's going to be done out there. We are going to be doing some work at different churches out there. And we're going to be going out there to just send, promote this school so we can have students and let them know how important or the importance of Christian education. And we pray for this school and we pray for them that what we will be going out to do will be a blessing for them. So that goes through that. I also want to let you know if you have young people, we have Academy Days, which is going to be March 31st to April 2nd. If you have young people, we invite you to come over and just have that experience of being in the dorm for the weekend and see the many scholarship that you will receive if you do decide to come to Jefferson Christian Academy. And then April, the third weekend of April, we have Alumni Weekend. I invite you to come if you are a parent, if you have young people that, you know, you don't have to graduate to be an alumni. Amen. If you attended, you registered even for a day, come out and celebrate with us Alumni Weekend. I know that I believe it's the threes, anything 63, 73, 83, 93. Those are the honor years for Alumni Weekend. So come out and join us. If you if you've been a part of Jefferson Christian Academy, come out and join us for Alumni Weekend. Once again, I want to say thank you for all of your help. Thank you for all of your support. And we are, you know, the school has been open since 1914. In 2003, we became a self-supporting ministry of the Seventh-day Adventist Church. And we are, you know, I know that there was a lot of people that said, that, you know, I don't know how long you would be open for if the conference is not supporting you. And you know what? God has other plans. God says we will leave the doors open. And every year in August, we pray when it's time for us to register a kid. And all we say is, God, if you want us to stay open, bring children. And every year he faithfully does so. So we thank God foremost for all of the blessings that he continues to give to the school. So thank you once again for allowing us to be here. And I pray that we will see each other again. But before I sit down, I have a lot of staff here, and I know they're not expecting this. But as I stand here, I see our staff, and I want to also introduce them. The whole back seat right there is all our staff, as you can see. Our English teacher, Ms. Vanessa Kerr. Please say hello, Vanessa. Okay. And then she's also not only our English teacher, she's also our girls' assistant dean. And then sitting next to her is Karen. Karen, she is our girls' head dean, and not only that, she cooks for us in the kitchen. And then next to her, who is that? Is that your boyfriend, Karen? Oh, no. Okay, that's your husband. That is Tom. Tom, he works with our medals. So, yes, if you have any medals that you don't want, please see Tom at Potluck or call the school, and we'll be glad to come and pick it up for you, and we do recycling. So that's what Tom does, and he also helps out in the kitchen with his girlfriend. And he comes out to the dorm, to the boys' dorm, and helps us out as well. Thank you, Tom, for your service. And sitting by Tom is we have Jannard. Jannard is our math teacher. And I know, he looks like a student. A lot of times when we go places, a lot of people think of him as, they think he's a student, but he's actually a teacher. So that's Jannard. And next to him is our boys' dean as well. Oh, and Jannard also works in the dorm. Next to him is Manny. And Manny helps out with our boys, and he also helps out with our Spanish teacher as well. So he's out there and helping out with that. Thank you, Manny. And he's our basketball coach too. So, and you see a lot of us here. My sister, she plays the piano. Her name is Mele. And then Willie's here. Willie, he's our. He does helps out in our maintenance, and he's our groundskeeper, and many other things that he does. And then you have my wife here. She's our choir, and she does work with our international kids, and of course our choir, and myself. My name is Pila, and I work at the dorm with those two boys out there, and we have a lot of fun with them. So thank you again for your support. I pray that God will continue to help the school, and that's all we ask for is prayers. That's what we need is prayers for these young people as they study, and we pray that they will be able to learn more about Christ and his soon coming. So they let them sing, and I know my wife always tells me I talk too much, so I let her.
We have two more songs to go, the first song is, I know that we always have a desire in our heart. We all sit here. We as parents, our desire is to see our children in heaven. More than anything, for them to be successful in life for sure, but at the same time to see them in heaven someday soon. And so I always say this. I know we're not too far from you guys, but if things happen that we don't get to see each other again, just be happy and know that we're going to see each other again in heaven soon. Joy comes in the morning. You know, from the last time I came here, I came with my brother. And he was the brass band person and helped with music as well. My brother Willie is now taking care of the brass. But that was a trip that I'll never forget, because he was just, we played in the beginning, we had the concert, we played at the end. And when we went to eat, we came back and played. It was just a day for him to play, I guess. But when we came in this morning, I can never stop but think of the fact that there'll be joy in my heart. There is joy when I know that I'll get to see him again. It's my prayer that we go through the same thing too. Mount Pleasant, I can't say the many things that you have done for the school, Billy has talked a lot of it, about a lot of it. But I know that I remember faces, and when I fail to say thank you, I ask the Lord to please make it up for me, because I know you've done more than you can. And when you can't give, pray for us. We really need it. We need it more than anyone could. And so with the first song of the two songs that we're going to sing, as joy comes in the morning, may you be lifted with the words of this song.
Tears often fall from my face in sorrow as I walk on through the long, lonely night, and often I cry, but it seems no one hears. Shadows, I can see the dawning of life.
Shadows of sin will vanish.
will be of no avail if we are going to do everything for Him and live for Him like we think, but never makes it to heaven. How many of you guys are willing to look for me in heaven? Jerusalem, that new Jerusalem, that will be our last song. And Angie, come sing with us. We have one of our students here who's no longer with us, but we'd like to have her over. That new Jerusalem, it is our prayer that we see each other up there.
That city he saw.
Yeah.
For our benediction, I would like to ask everyone to please stand. And I'm going to ask Earl to come and close us with prayer.
Our heads. Our kind Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for you dying on the cross for us. We thank you for everything you do. We thank you for this school. Lord, we just want to give you praise. I want you to watch over, protect us, bless us, and help us to do the things that are pleasing to you. These things we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.